Hey, how's it going? Welcome back to my channel. Today I'm here to wrap up all the books that I've read for the PopCulture Readathon for the round that took place in January. I really enjoyed this experience. It was the first time I participated in this readathon. 90% of my personality is just quoting old movies to people or saying, remember when in that movie this person did that? And I think that's why I really love the concept of the readathon itself. The PopCulture Readathon is created by Whitney and Lo. I'm going to leave their Twitter handles in the description box. Go follow them and also follow the official Twitter of the readathon because they recently announced the new round, I think. I'm not especially interested in it because I'm not familiar with the TV show they're basing their prompts on, but I'm definitely going to participate in the future if they're going to do rounds on stuff that I actually know about. So for this round, you could choose between three sheets. It's basically nine movies on one sheet and prompts that correlate with each movie. I've chosen the Elm Street sheet and I have not completed the assignment. I have not read nine books. I've read only five, I believe, but I'm quite happy with that too. Plus the sheet had some of my favorite movies. Let's just jump into the prompts and what I've read for them. So for Vampire Lore, I've read Better of Red by Rebekah Weatherspoon and gave this book 3 stars. It's an FF vampire erotica about a vampire nest that is masquerading as a sorority. And it follows a girl named Ginger. She goes to the first year of uni and is assigned a new roommate named Emmy. Emmy is harmless but a little bit annoying, and she wants to get into a sorority, so she begs Ginger to go to Russia's with her, and that's how they meet the Alpha Beta Omega sorority, which is pretty mysterious and unusual in the way it operates. Ginger and Emmy immediately are obsessed with these girls, and Ginger even develops a crush on one of them. So when they are invited to join the sorority, they say yes. They're taken out of their rooms into the sorority's house to pass a very odd hazing ritual, which involves being semi-naked and exchanging blood with ethereal looking women that are not entirely human. This book was fun and dirty. I kinda wanted it to be a bit more than that, and I wanted to know more about the lore behind these vampires. It's not a spoiler, the series already is called the Vampire Sorority series, so you kind of know that it's about a vampire sorority. And I thought that Ginger and her love interest Camilla got together way too quickly for me to really get invested in their romance. Overall, I found this book to be enjoyable, but I just wanted a little bit more from it. This one I recommend if you're looking for something smutty and outrageous and you don't really care for the logistics of it. I did a whole vlog on it. It has a few minor spoilers, so if you're interested in more details about the book, you can just watch that vlog. Another prompt that I completed was 3-word title, and for that I read They Never Learn by Layne Fargo. I give this book 4 stars. It's a thriller about a revenge serial killer. It's about this woman who's a professor in uni that in her free time kills men that assaulted or raped women in the past. She stages all the murders to look like accidents, and at the start of the novel she is determined to kill one of her colleagues, but the police already is trying to uncover a lot of her murders, so they're starting to make rounds around her. There is a second point of view character that is a student. She comes from a very abusive household. Her father is a complete piece of shit that intimidates her and her mother, and she's very happy to get out of her childhood house and to start a new chapter. The way these two characters are connected was not a big surprise for me, but there are still quite a few plot twists in this. I enjoyed this, even though at times it was a bit too long and meandering, but I found that the story was very unique and the last few chapters are just compulsively readable. The story was also surprisingly very queer because both point of view characters are bisexual. For murder mystery, I finally picked up Hither Page by Sebastian, which is a cozy mystery with an MM romantic subplot. I found this book to be very soothing but also very short. I wanted to fall in love with the characters and to see more of them, but this was supposed to be a novella and I knew it before going into it, so I didn't know why I'm complaining. This was absolutely charming and surprising in a way because I had no idea what it's going to be about. Turns out it's about a spy named Leo who, after the Second World War, is still working for the secret agency and is eliminating traitors of the crown. It's set in England. So Leo is sent to the small village to investigate a death of this random woman who worked in the house of the rich colonel. They think that this guy was supposed to be eliminated in her stead, but there was a mix-up and she drank the poison instead of him. Lee arrives to the village expecting this to be an easy job, but the lives of his villagers are more complicated and intertwined than he expected, and he also catches the eye of the young doctor that works and lives in this village. He can't shake the feeling that he'd seen him before. Overall, I found this story to be very sweet and wholesome, even though it's about murder, but you know how cozy mysteries are. I give it 3 stars though, because cozy mysteries are just not the genre that I generally love. I like the experience of reading it, but I didn't love it. Cozy mysteries lack the shock value that I like to get from mysteries and thrillers, so I generally like them less. They're usually a bit more predictable. The next prompt that I completed was Holy Centered, and I finally read Mangoes and Mistletoe by Adriana Herrera, and I hated it. I gave it 2 stars. I didn't really hate the romance necessarily, I just disliked one of the characters. She was so annoying, I could not handle her. She reminded me of this obnoxious girl that I met in my pre-uni lectures that literally knew me for a couple of hours and decided to start telling me about her sex life with her boyfriend, and I loathed her so much. I was so uncomfortable the whole time. She for some reason decided that we were going to be friends, and didn't help that we lived in a same general direction, so every single time I went to these lectures she came back to the subway station with me and went into the subway with me and constantly talked about her nonsense. I was elated when in first year it turned out that she actually chose a different uni to attend, because I was on the verge of snapping. In the story that is set in UK, there are 2 female characters that are both from Dominican Republic but that come from different circumstances. Both of them are queer and they are assigned to be partners in this cooking TV show that reminds me a lot of the British Bake Off. One of them is a person that I would never want to be in the presence of. She assumed a lot, she constantly talked, she constantly wanted to raise a reaction from the other heroine. I couldn't stand her. So, of course, because I didn't like one of the characters, I wasn't into the romance too, because the whole time I was surprised that the other heroine is attracted to this girl. I didn't like it, it wasn't for me. I'm not sure if the other books by Adriana Herrera are going to be better, if it's the type of character that she writes in all of her books, because sometimes it happens with authors, they love a certain archetype. But if not, I would actually like to check out her other books. Tell me in the comments down below if you read anything else by her and you loved it. And then I decided to cheat and read a book that was not on the sheet. It was the bonus book for the sheet. The prompt was LGBTQIA rap. And I really wanted to read Black Sun by Rebekah and Roanhorse. I do not regret this choice because I absolutely loved this book. I adored it. I give it 5 stars. It's the first 5 star of 2021 for me. When I say I loved it, you need to understand that I loved it. It was so good. It was adventurous. It gave me a sense of wonder that I missed. The world building is very fascinating. It is inspired by pre-Columbian Americas. And in this book, we follow a bunch of characters pre-solar eclipse, which coincides with a religious celebration in this city named Tova. The first character is the sun priest that wants to bridge the divide between the tower, which is a religious institution in Tova, the regular people and the clans. She feels the internal turmoil in the city and she wants to be the one to smooth it over. But she doesn't realize that one of the clans, named the Karen Crow, is fed up with the status quo, and they were praying for their old god named the Crow God to get back to life. One of the Karen Crows saw a prophecy, and in it she was told that her son is going to be the vessel for the Crow God. So she did what she had to do to ensure that he, Serapio, is gonna be sent on his way to Tova at the proper time. At the start of the novel, Serapio, who's a very, very interesting character, is on the ship that is bound to Tova, and they're supposed to arrive in the city before the solar eclipse. As you can tell, something has to happen during the solar eclipse, but we are not told what exactly. The book is structured in a very cool way because each chapter peels off a new layer and you get a peek of a new secret. The characters in this were so cool. Usually when you get multiple point of views, there are certain characters that are more interesting than others, but in this case I feel like each character has the potential to be someone's favorite. I loved Serapio and Ciala the most because I found them the most mysterious and their chemistry is off the roof, but I also wasn't bored with other characters. I was very, very invested in the story. I cannot wait to see what's gonna happen in the second book, because the way the first one ended left me with a lot of questions. The last book that I picked up during PopCulture Readathon was The Little Stranger by Sarah Waters, but I only got to read about 20 pages of it, so I don't think it's gonna be fair to give an opinion on it. I will try to read it for a different video. I'm going to show you the sheet now, so you would be able to see which prompts I completed and which I didn't. The other 5 prompts that I didn't complete are Haunted House. I wanted to read The Little Stranger for that. I didn't complete Middle Grade Horror because I don't really care about middle grade or horror. The next one was Family Dynamics. I wanted to read Jade City for that, but Jade City is a very, very thick book, so I'm actually reading it right now and really enjoying it. And there are 2 more prompts. One is Failure, and the other one is space opera. I think the prompts are cleverly chosen. They are not all the same, and you can actually find a lot of books on your existing TBR for them because they are not extremely specific. I definitely enjoyed the experience. If you also participated in PopCulture Readathon, tell me in the comments down below and tell me which sheet you had chosen and which books you've read for it. If you have any recommendations for me for books that you think I'm going to enjoy, or readathons that you think I'm going to enjoy, leave them in the comments down below as well. If you reach this part of the video, leave the emoji of the Black Sun. I think we have that one. Obviously, it's inspired by Black Sun by Rebekah, Roanhorse. That's it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it, and I'll see you soon with another one, but until then,